Welcome back, class 10. Today, continuing with your history class, chapter 4, we will discuss some of the outstanding leaders of assertive nationalism. Basically, there is a trio. Trio means three people. Lal Bal Pal or Pal Pal Lal, anyone, any way you can say. Lal Bal Pal means Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Bipin Chandra Pal. They were the three main assertive nationalists. So let me start off with Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Bal Gangadhar Tilak was born on July 23rd, 1856. He was the real founder of the popular anti-imperialist movement in India. The Deccan Education Society was founded under Ranade's guidance. A number of patriotic Indians, including Gokhale and Tilak, were associated with the activities of the society. So, Bal Gangadhar Tilak was associated to Deccan Education Society. Members of the society offered their services as teachers on a nominal salary. Thus, it was possible without large funds to start many educational institutions, including the famous Ferguson College at Pune. So, many educational institutes, national educational institutes, were opened. They imparted education. Teachers were also appointed at nominal salary. Tilak's contribution to the freedom struggle. What was Tilak's contribution to freedom struggle? Number one, Tilak's political beliefs. Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it. It was Bal Gangadhar Tilak's key message. Tilak talked of Swaraj as early as 1896-97. He said, Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it. Swaraj and Swadeshi had become the battle cry or the war cry of those robust nationalists. After Surat split, they left Congress and in 1908, Tilak was sentenced to 6 years of imprisonment. Tilak was the first one who gave this cry that Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it. Bitter attacks on government. Year after year, Congress passed nearly the same resolutions without much effort on the government. Tilak therefore came to the conclusion that reforms would be secured by talk, not by talk, by action. So he started giving pressure to the British, because the Congress, year after year, it passed the same resolution. Means employed to expose administration, to mobilize masses and arouse nationalistic passions. What did Tilak do? Tilak adopted many methods to carry the agitation. Agitation means disturbance or revolution to the masses. He started Ganapati festival and Shivaji festival. First, he started Ganapati festival. Satisfied with that festival, he started Shivaji festival. Why? To arouse the patriotic feelings. To arouse the patriotic feelings among the masses, among the people. The object was to instill means put, in the masses a spirit of discipline and patriotism. Then wrestling places or akharas were opened. Lathi clubs, lathi practices were done. Why? Because they wanted the desi culture or the culture of India to be revived. And in 1896, what happened was, he led a no-rent campaign where he asked the cultivators not to pay land revenue because famine conditions were there in Deccan. So these are all his work. Then also what happened, his role in the anti-partition movement. What was Bal Gangadhar Tilak's role in anti-partition movement? Partition of Bengal gave him a big opportunity to expose the evil designs of the government. Leaders like Tilak, Bipin Chandra and Lala Lajpat Rai transformed the anti-partition movement into a movement for Swaraj. Then, Home Rule Movement. The year 1916 saw the establishment of Home Rule Leagues in Madras and Maharashtra. Two leagues were led by Annie Besant and Tilak separately. Two Home Rule Movement, one was led by Annie Besant and another was led by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. The movement which infused the nation with new strength and vigor. It gave the nation new strength and vigor. Vigor means energy. Tilak's contribution made him a hero of the masses. And then from that moment, he was started to known as, to be called as Lokmanya. Lokmanya Tilak. Lokmanya Tilak means respected or revered by people, and almost he was worshipped as God. Lokmanya Tilak, Bal Gangadhar Tilak was worshipped as God. He was such a respected leader. So you have to know all these things. Forerunner of Gandhiji. Question comes. Forerunner means ahead of Gandhiji. Although Mahatma Gandhi regarded Gokhale as his political guru, his ideals were molded by Tilak in a big way. Gandhi laid great stress on prohibition, Swadeshi and boycott. All these things were preached and practiced by Tilak much before Gandhiji. Gandhi's ideal of complete independence were similar to Tilak's idea of Swaraj. The movements launched by Tilak were precursors, means came before, of what was to come in the Gandhian era. So whatever Tilak said and did, Gandhiji also said the same thing and he did the same thing. But Tilak did it much before Gandhiji. So that is why Tilak was known as forerunner of Gandhi. Question has come and question will come in future also. So you should know why Tilak was called the Tilak was known as the forerunner of Gandhi. Tilak's scholarly activity. Scholarly means educational pursuit. What he did as an educationist. Tilak was a profound scholar. He was a very well learned man, well lettered man, well versed man, and writer of great fame. As a scholar, he has three great works to his credit. As a scholar, he has three great works. One, Gita Rahasya. Two, The Orion. And three, The Arctic Home in Vedas. He died in the year 1920 on 1st August. As one of the makers of Indian nation, Tilak has won an undying fame. He is still famous today. Next comes Bipin Chandra Pal. Bipin Chandra Pal was a prophet of bold, self-reliant nationalism. He was bold. He said India should be self-reliant. He was born in 1858 in Sylhet, now in Bangladesh. His career started as a headmaster of high school in Cuttack. Later he served as headmaster of high school in Bangalore. In 1876, Bipin Chandra Pal joined the Brahmo Samaj. In his later life, he became a total convert of Hindu, Orthodox Hindu. He started as a Brahmo, then later he became a Hindu. Number one, his contribution. His role in awakening national consciousness in India. Bipin Chandra joined Congress in 1887. At the Chennai Congress, he made a forceful speech and where he pleaded that Arms Act should be repelled, Arms Act should be taken away or suspended. He participated in several sessions of Congress and contributed greatly to the growth of national consciousness in India. Number two, great journalist and a marvelous orator. Orator means speaker. Bipin Chandra was a great journalist. He edited several papers. Among important were New India, In an article he wrote, individuals are born, individuals die, but the nation liveth forever. That means individuals are born, individual dies, but nation lives. That is how people were being asked to make great sacrifices. Bipin Chandra Pal was a marvelous orator and he roused masses with his oratory. He gave such fiery speech that people got that, you know, a patriotic feeling among them. He had a very active role during anti-partition and Swadeshi movement. During the anti-partition movement, he toured several parts of the country. He carried the message of boycott and Swadeshi. And he gave several speeches in Madras in 1907. Now, he made great sacrifices because of his robust nationalism. After Surat session, that means the Surat split, Bipin parted company with early nationalists. He left the company of the early nationalists. Because he stood for stronger methods of agitation. He said that agitation should be very strong. Great hardships or sufferings was the practice that had to be paid off for freedom. Matlab means that if you want freedom, you have to practice hardship. It's not a very easy thing. If you don't practice hardship, if you don't do sacrifice, freedom will not be achieved. Aurobindo Ghosh, the editor of Vande Mataram, was charged with sedition. Sedition means it's a charge where you are arrested for doing anti-nationalist activity. Aurobindo Ghosh was charged. The government wanted Bipin Chandra's testimony in this case. Testimony means you have to say something for the case, so that he arrested, he wanted that you have to say for that case, so Aurobindo Ghosh will be arrested. Since he refused to give evidence, testimony means evidence, you have to give evidence for the case. He was imprisoned for 6 months. Bipin Chandra Pal was released on March 9, 1908. He had his own idea of national education. He said that passion should be aroused for nationalism. People should be more interested in nationalistic approach towards education, and it would become an effective instrument for social progress, he also said. Above all, it is the key which opens the great treasures of Indian philosophy and culture of Indians. He said that through national education, great treasure of nationalist philosophy, Indian philosophy, could be opened. Bipin Chandra Pal became impatient with Gandhian methods. Bipin Chandra Pal did not support non-cooperation movement launched by Gandhi. He was of the opinion that Indians should resort to a sterner measure, stronger measure, instead of launching movement like non-cooperation. He did not like non-cooperation. Bipin Chandra Pal was a writer of a great fame. He was a very famous writer. His publications included The Spirit of Indian Nationalism and The New Economic Menace of India. He said that to get rid of Indian poverty, Bipin Chandra said, to develop lot of industries in the country and to tax the rich heavily so that it can be, poor could be given the money. That means money could be available to the poor. And he also said, 48 hours of work in a week with an increase in wages and the practice of Swadeshi and boycott. So this was his economic ideas. Okay. He also said, Bipin Chandra also said, the Swadeshi and boycott should become a means of freedom. But he passed away in the year 1932. But his contribution will be remembered. And it is still remembered even today. That is where we are standing and we are giving respect to him. So that is all for today. We'll continue our history class, and at the next class we will discuss Lala Lajpat Rai. Thank you very much.